I intend to get out. my opinion, the most desirable roommates.
Okay, no wrong with that. But your staff here are most where they don't have roaches.
You mean that you insist upon having the roaches?
No, I mean I insist upon having the rent you owe me.
Right at the moment, this is out of the question.
Out of the question, is it?
Yes, and I'll tell you why. The quarterly payments that I received from the man who is taking care of the rubber plantation have not been forwarded yet. I've been expecting them to come in for several weeks now, but in the letter that I received this morning, it seems there has been so little misunderstanding about the last year taxes.
Oh, no, stop it! I've had enough of the god of rubber plantation, the Brazilian rubber plantation. You think of being in this business for 17 years without learning nothing about your kind of women?
What is the implication in that regard?
I suppose that the man that you have in here now is coming to discuss the Brazilian rubber plantation, right?
You must be crazy to say such a thing.
I hear what I hear and I know what's going on.
I know you respect. I know you listen at doors.
What? I never spoil you. I never listen at doors. This blockhead here, as you may all have noticed, he's taken me for nobody. What's more? She's taken me for a busybody. What's the implication in my remark, she dares to ask? What's the implication in hers? I will show her the kind of woman I am. You see, the first thing an aunt lady in the French Quarter learns is not to see I'm not here, but only to collect your money. As long as that comes in, okay. I'm blind and deaf and dumb, but soon as it stops, I recover my sight. I recover my hearing. Even the use of my voice. And I trust my that I remember all the money.
What argument? What money?
Really? He shouted so loud they had to shut the front windows and keep the noise from carrying out on the streets. I heard the mention of any Brazilian plantation. And plenty of all the things that they refer to in that little midnight conversation you have. Larkspur lotion to take the polish off nails. Am I in my infancy? Am I? That's on a par with the wonderful rubber plantation.
Stop!
Oh, it's you.
Stop persecuting this little...
The second Mr. Shakespeare enters the scene.
I heard your demon howling in my sleep.
Sleep? I think that what you mean is you're drunk, stop!
I rest because of my illness.
Illness? Oh, God! Not trying to pull that phone over my eyes. Now, I'm glad that you're coming now that I repeat for your benefit what I just said to this little woman. I am done with that bit. Is that plain to you? Huh? Completely fed up with all of you water rats, half-wits, drunkards, degenerates, who try to get by your promises, lies, delusions!
Please! Stop joking! It's not necessary!
You with your Brazilian rubber plantation. That coat of arms that you got from the junction. The woman who sold it, told me. One of the Habsburgs?
Yes.
A kind old lady, the Lady of Larkspur Lotion, there's your title.
Stop badgering this unfortunate little woman. Is there no mercy left in the world anymore? What has become of compassion and understanding? Where have they all gone to? Where is Christ? Where is God? What if there is no Brazilian rubber plantation?
I tell you, there is! There is!
What if there is no rubber king in her life? There ought to be rubber kings in her life! Is this little woman to be blamed because it's necessary for her to compensate for the cruel deficiencies of reality by the exercise of a little, what shall I say, God-given imagination?
No, it isn't imagination.
I'll ask you to please stop stabbing me in the face of high-flown speeches. You with your 780-page masterpiece, right on a par with the Lady of Larkspur Lotion as far as the use of nation's concerned.
Oh, well, what if I am... Suppose there is no 780-page masterpiece in existence. Suppose there is in existence no masterpiece whatsoever. What of that, Mrs. Wyatt? But a few, a very few vain scribblings in my old trunk bottom. Suppose I wanted to be a great artist, but I lacked the force and the power. Suppose my books fell short of the final chapter. Even my verses languished uncompleted. Suppose the curtains of my exalted fancies rose in magnificent drama, but the house lights darkened before the curtain fell. And suppose that I, stumbling from bar to bar, from drink to drink, till at last I... till at last I sprawl on the lice-infested mattress of this brothel. Suppose that I, to make nightmare bearable for as long as I must continue to be the helpless protagonist of it. Suppose that I illuminate, ornament, glorify it with dreams and fictions and fantasies. Suppose that I live in this world of pitiful fiction. What satisfaction can it give to you, good woman, to crush it, tear it to pieces, call it a lie? Now listen! There are no lies, but the lies that are stuffed in the mouth by the hard-knuckled hand of me, the cold iron fist of necessity. Mrs. Liar, so I am a liar? Yes, but your world is built on a lie. Your world is built on a hideous fabrication of lies, liars, liars.
Matisse!
That was it! I have no money to give you. So leave this woman in peace. Get out! Get away!
Thank you, Mr. Chekhov.